always from the heart of the city, and now on demand 24/7 on the CHFI website. This is the soundtrack to accompany an original. And I'm Don Jackson, around the world on the internet. Rilke wrote, "One single rose is all roses. And this particular one, unique, perfect, a supple word with which to speak the text of all things." This hour, an original, with lovers and other strangers, from iTunes and CHFI.com. Ray Charles with Natalie Cole and Fever and Natasha Bedingfield, Unwritten. I'm Don Jackson with lovers and other strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. You've heard it tell that no two snowflakes are exactly alike. No two individuals are alike either. I took my children for their eye appointments just the other day. On the wall outside the examination room are the most incredible photographs. They are extreme close-ups of the human eye. In fact, many different eyes. As fingerprints are unique, apparently so are the eyes. I told my daughter that's why there will soon be eye scans as means of identification. There was once a TV series that focused on people who could be called originals. You might remember it. I think we are all originals. The problem is that something happens to sap our originality along the road of life. Rachel Carson, in The Sense of Wonder, published by Harper and Row, wrote, "If I had influence with the good fairy, who is supposed to preside over the christening of all children, I should ask that her gift to each child be a sense of wonder so indestructible that it would last throughout life. An unfailing antidote against the boredom and disenchantment of later years, the sterile preoccupation with things that are artificial, the alienation from the sources of our strength. If a child is to keep alive his inborn sense of wonder without any such gift from the fairies, he needs the companionship of at least one adult who can share it, rediscovering with him the joy, excitement, and mystery of the world we live in." Rachel Carson, from The Sense of Wonder, published by Harper and Row. You must remember the film Jonathan Livingston Seagull, based on the novella by Richard Bach. As it said in Video Hound's Golden Movie Retriever, based on the best-selling novella, this film quietly envisions a world of love, understanding, achievement, hope, and individuality. Unquote. Lovers and other strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. Coldplay and Ticking Clocks, and Five for Fighting with The Riddle. I'm Don Jackson with lovers and author strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. Charles R. Brown wrote, "We are not hen's eggs or bananas or clothespins to be counted off by the dozen. Down to the last detail, we are all different. Everyone has his own fingerprints. Recognize and rejoice in that endless variety. The white light of the divine purpose streams down from heaven to be broken up by these human prisms into all the colors of the rainbow. Take your own color in the pattern and be just that. I'm Don Jackson from CHFI.com. Amanda Marshall and Believe in You, Chicago, Color My World, and Mark Cohn with The Things We've Handed Down. I'm Don Jackson with Lovers and Other Strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. Goethe wrote, "People are always talking about originality, but what do they mean? As soon as we are born, the world begins to work upon us, and this goes on to the end. What can we call our own except energy, strength, and will? If I could give an account of all that I owe to great predecessors and contemporaries, there would be but a small balance in my favor." And Daphne Rose Kingma, in her book A Garland of Love, Daily Reflections on the Magic and Meaning of Love, published in 1992 by Canary Press, wrote, and I quote, "Love never lets us vegetate, simply lay back and soak up the goodies. It asks us to see who we are, to be bigger and more, to become who in the original, infinite, and eternal pattern we were intended to be." And Eric Hoffer, quoted in the August 20th, 08 issue of the Globe and Mail's Social Studies column, said, "The less satisfaction we derive from being ourselves, the greater is our desire to be like others." Lovers and Author Strangers, from iTunes and CHFI.com, I'm Don Jackson. Celine Dion, Because You Loved Me, and Phil Collins, True Colors. I'm Don Jackson with Lovers and Author Strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. I have a friend who did carpentry work on the Parliament buildings in Ottawa some years back. He did some intricate work on one of the large doorways to chambers. His special name, his mark, is inscribed on that very personal work. It reminded me of this excerpt from the 1990 edition of the friendship book of Francis Gay, published by D.C. Thompson & Company. Gay writes, and I quote, "People have always liked to leave their trademark. When stonemasons had finished a piece of work in a cathedral, they always carved their own special mark on it. Likewise, for 600 years, gold and silver objects have been hallmarked to ensure uniform quality and to prevent fraud." Originally, the maker stamped an emblem on his work, such as a bird or a cross. But that was when few people could read. Nowadays, the maker's initials are used, and from them, an expert can tell the date and maker of any piece he examines. We may think we have no extraordinary talents, but we can each leave a trademark that singles us out as unique. How do we do it? Simply by being ourselves. Lovers and Author Strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. Deborah Cox and Beautiful You Are, and Burton Cummings with A Dream. I'm Don Jackson with Lovers and Other Strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. Leo Biscaglia, in his book Born for Love, published by Slack, wrote, and I quote, "The majority of us lead quiet, unheralded lives as we pass through this world. There will most likely be no ticker tape parades for us, no monuments created in our honor. But that does not lessen our possible impact, for there are scores of people who will appreciate our compassion, our encouragement, who will need our unique talents. Someone who will live a happier life merely because we took the time to share what we had to give. Too often, we underestimate the power of a touch, a smile, a kind word, a listening ear, an honest compliment, or the smallest act of caring, all of which have the potential to turn a life around. It's overwhelming to consider the continuous opportunities there are to make our love felt. Leo Biscaglia from Born for Love, published by Slack. And one final thought this hour from John W. Walker, and featured in the March 1983 issue of the Reader's Digest, he said, and I quote, "With the falling of the leaves, the masks of green are stripped off the hillsides, revealing the diversity and uniqueness of each ridge and valley, rock and stream, old shed or oil well hitherto unseen. It is in the winter, when the hills bear their innermost selves, that we get to know them. Then, in the spring, when the masks return, we can look at the hills as old friends few others understand. So it is with people. Most of the time we wear our masks. But during the difficult times, during the winters of our lives, we shed our facades and reveal all the intricacies of the unique beings we are. It is in these moments that friendships are formed, and we experience one another as few others ever will. The words of John W. Walker from a past issue of the Reader's Digest. I hope you will tell all your friends about Lovers and Other Strangers. From iTunes and CHFI.com. Good night, sweet dreams. I'm Don Jackson.